So, cutting out at the end of the boundary trail. This is the radio mast. There used to be a lot more things on it. At least I'm sure there used to be a lot more things on it. It seems pretty dead now. I still hear some power in it, but very few instruments left. One thing I do know was on there, I don't know if it's still there. There's an ozone collector for, I think it's the Roslin Institute. And they have their equipment in there, or they had their equipment. I did that on work experience. A weird work experience, mostly laying around in the forest and getting eaten by midges. While measuring the effect of ozone on plants, trees and stuff. That was weird. Oh, this is funky. Yeah. And this is the cake. Off to the right is the link to Spooky Wood. Not doing that, doing this. This is Boundary Trail. Well, it will be Boundary Trail one. Once we get to the start of it. Yep, if you are riding up the Spooky Wood climb, you don't quite fancy the jumps and stuff the Spooky Wood, because it is man-made. It's good, but it's not natural. We'll be honest, it's a very clean trail. I still love it, but it's a clean trail. Whereas this one here is a lot more natural, and just as fun, I think. In fact, probably more fun. Spooky Wood, I'd probably rate about an 8. A red trail anyway. Or this one. See how it's there than what I find here. Because I haven't been out here for a while. That's quite a bit of snow up there. See how it's there over the past 2 years. Okay, this is going to be interesting. It's a trout! This is what I don't do when they grab lunch. I hit the snow and die. Boundary trail. Almost. Get to the top here. Get to the top here.